Hello, everyone. This is Iceblood. Welcome back to Final Fantasy XIV. We're just going to jump right in too quickly. This one asks Dancing One forgiveness. Have many troubles. Must be careful. Always careful. But Dancing One is not like other walking ones. This one can trust Dancing One. This one would ask Dancing One for help. Sure. Strange walking ones with bodies of steel come to the home of these ones. This one thinks steel ones come from Empire. Not the Empire, no. Where Empire goes, many living ones become dead ones. Trees fall and bushes burn. These ones' home is in danger. Danger! This one begs of Dancing One to help this one no more. Dancing One is friends with these ones and walking ones, yes. Dancing One must speak to these ones here and walking ones in Hut House and find out more. This one has bad feeling. This one fears steel ones are after something, but this one should speak no more. Go, Dancing One. This one depends on kindness of Dancing One. Very well. We will speak to the citizenry and see what they've found regarding the nefarious Empire. Say it isn't so. No. Strange steel walking ones are about. Yes, this one has seen steel walking ones carry big boxes. Maybe walking ones hunt for shiny treasure. This one likes treasure. That's probably what they're doing. They're probably looking for treasure. That's probably exactly what... Well, that's actually... I mean, they're looking for world domination, right? Because they're an evil, nefarious empire. Clearly, they're after something. And... I mean, you know, world domination comes with loot, right? Treasure and probably slaves and wheat, whatever. Anyway, shush, shush, this one says. Steel walking ones are scary, like touched ones. This one hates scary, and scary ones have scary friends. Okay, that's another good point. Does the Garlean Empire have any allies, or do they all just kind of... get assimilated into the machine? Because, you know, the Empire. Empires are always bad. That's the golden rule of fictional kingdoms and such. Republics are fine, kingdoms are cool. Empires, though. Oh, no, no, no. You don't want to be part of an empire. So, you know, I'm not entirely sure they have any allies. They're just too evil for that. They have subjects and such. This is... Ooh! A rogue. I think. Pretty sure that's a rogue. Or, I mean, it's either a rogue or a ninja. But I think with the level range of this zone, it's probably a rogue. Anyway. So we're going back to Hawthorne Hut. We're gonna talk to the... these walking ones. And see what they've found. This is kind of where... I feel like this is kind of where things start to really amp up the main threat. The main threat being the Garlean Empire. Because, like, that was a big to-do in the original game, and the way that it actually transitioned into this one was actually, like, the calamity that we saw in the very beginning. That's what happened in the core game. So this is where things start getting interesting. Fearsome types clad head-to-toe in steel, you say? Imperial soldiers, no doubt. I couldn't tell you what they're plotting, but I'm sure it's nothing good. This is starting to seem rather biased. You want to tell me everyone in the Empire is an evil, mustache-twirling villain? Probably. That's probably what it is. What do you have to say, though? Men clad in strange armor? Well, now that you mention it, I did see some suspicious types of late. They were gathering deep in the forest. I simply assumed they were adventurers. I mean, it's probably a decent guess, but, it's not really all that good. That would be an easy way to infiltrate. Whoops, wrong button. Here we go. Here we are. We travel in style. Or invisible. That's great. Alright. Yeah, like, the Empire, when they're, like, scouting Eorzean lands and such, they probably don't wear their, like, insignias, or at least I hope they wouldn't, you know, have, like, you know, defining marks, emblems, and uniforms and shit like that. Like, that would be very, very dangerous. So they probably do mask their intentions by looking like adventurers. That'd be pretty smart, actually. All right, Kamukio, we found things, I think. They're definitely the Empire, so let's see. What do we got? What do you think now? This one is happy to see Dancing One return. What did Dancing One learn? This one sees steel walking ones come from Empire, carry boxes and go walking deep, deep through trees. As this one thought, steel walking ones are up to nasty, no good things. That's probably true. This one knows forest well. Steel walking ones try to hide, but this one will find them. This one would borrow Dancing One's map. This one makes mark right here. This is where steel ones hide. This one knows. Dancing One will go looking for steel ones. Yes. Sure. Yeah. All right. I will be your errand boy. Why not? That's what adventurers are for. Yes, of course. It's interesting that I still get gil for these quests. You wouldn't think the sylphs would deal in the currency of the realm. You think they'd give me milk root or those weird mushrooms that we got last time or something. I don't know. But anyway, we're tracking down the Empire. We fought them before, technically. There's a quest right after we get our grand company that has us face off against the Empire. But, you know, this still feels interesting. There's definitely a very, like, Roman feel to a lot of this, because you can't tell me these titles are not Latin. I can't pronounce half of them. I mean, Secutor, Equus, Signifier, I don't know. Maybe that's a typo, but I doubt it. Signifier. I don't know, there's a very... They picked their names right for these enemies here. To really make it seem like, you know what, I don't trust these fuckers. I don't know what their titles mean, or what kind of rank these folks might have, but I really don't trust the names that they give it. So, I don't know, I wouldn't trust a Signifer no matter what they were wearing. It's just not good business. So, we found the boxes that they carried, but we don't know what they're for. Which is a common enough occurrence in quests like this. We just, hey, we found some shit. It could be a bomb. I'm just going to waltz it over here to the town where all the innocents are. This will be safe. Everything will be fine. I'm just jostling it around in my pack filled with a bunch of other crap. Nothing bad will happen. Dancing One is back. This one breathes a sigh of relief. This one was worried. Dancing One found something. Yes, this one did. This one found... a few somethings, actually. Dancing One found paper inside a box. This is a message from Empire. Oh, we didn't grab the box themselves. We grabbed it. Okay. This one can read Walking One's symbols. Message paper has names of food and rocks. Food and rocks were inside boxes. This one knows. Oh. Okay. But this one does not understand. Food and rocks mentioned all come from home of these ones. How do steel walking ones know to find them? Is there a sneaky one hiding behind this one's wings? Snooping one selling secrets to steel walking ones? I mean, it's probable, I would assume. This one fears for this one's home, but Dancing One has helped this one much today. Dancing One must promise to always be friend to these ones. Oh, of course. See, we get gil and high potion and such. I don't know why they have gil, but let's see what happens. Let's see what's next. What's the next leg of the journey here? Helpful One arrives at a good... we have a new title. This one needs Helpful One's help. That seems fitting. One of these ones, named Claxio, ventured outside Little Solace alone. Alone is unsafe. Helpful One must find Claxio. Oh, he must he? Very well, this one will do it. Claxio struck west after leaving the settlement. Hurry before Claxio ends up in the belly of a beastly one. All right, then. So we're trying to find another so forth. Here's something important. We're trying to ingratiate ourselves to the locals, and clearly this is the way to do it. We save their missing ones, and we help their waylaid ones, and we dance for their, I don't know, skeptical ones. I'm not sure how the whole nomenclature works here, but hey, this was easy. What? Walking One wants this one to return to Little Solace. Don't make this one laugh. This one is weary of living with those who are not these ones. This one wants to be alone. Oh, it's the angsty running away from home stage. These ones rely on Walking Ones for everything. No better than those ones that summoned a primal one. Small wonder this one chose to leave. Of course it was. This one thought that this a likely place to build a home, but then Meddling One arrives, forces this one to go deeper into the forest. Meddling One is forbidden from following this one. Away with Meddling One! Oh, well, we're forbidden. We can't do anything now. What are we gonna do? Like, no. Oh, I guess we're gonna go back and tell him. Like, I don't know why it wasn't... Why couldn't they find him? He was right there. He didn't seem to be inclined to move anywhere. He wanted to build a home there. That wouldn't have been hard. Maybe build a party of searching ones. I don't know. Anyway, we found him. He's all emo and angsty and whatnot. What? Plexio refused to return to these ones and went deeper into the forest. But this one saw touched ones lurking in the forest. Helpful one must hurry. Hurry and find Plexio. Oh, fine. Helpful one should search for pieces of thread on the forest floor. These things will lead helpful one to Claxio. But hurry, hurry before touched ones take Claxio away. Yes, yes, of course. Of course, we will do that. It is in our nature, shall we say, to do helpful things. We're helpful one now. We're not even just dancing one. We have to help now because we're helpful. Shouldn't be all that hard. I doubt he flies all that fast. Certainly he's not fast enough to keep away from a behemoth. Look at this thing. It's magnificent. It can't, you know. I have a couple new mounts that I'm going to be trying out, actually. We got that broom that I want to fly around on. That thing's pretty cool. And then I actually broke down finally and bought the Odin mount, the Sleipnir mount, because I wanted to support the company, and it looked really freaking cool. So I have that now too, but for now, this is an earlier bit of footage, so we're still using Behemoth. And we found thread, although it wasn't all sparkly and whatnot, so apparently we're not supposed to pick it up. Oh, here we go, it's one of these quests, I see. Alright, so we're going to have an instance battle here. Very well. We are above level 26, actually. Quite a bit ahead. 26 is usually the high end of what you're supposed to be, like in this quest, apparently, because that's usually how these are made, but we're way ahead of 26, so... Alright, we're ahead of schedule. Excellent. Meddling One is back. This one told Meddling One to be gone. Tell Camuxio that this one will never go back. Never! Ah ha ha ha. Or whatever. I can't do that. That's not an option. Besides, like, you know, look at that. Touched ones should go away too. This one is good one. Everyone should just leave this one alone. Unlikely. They're purple. That clearly means they're evil. Oh, hi, guys. Be on guard, Elyon. These sylphs have been tempered, brought under the thrall of the primal Ramu. Wasn't Ramu supposed to be the reasonable one? Like, is that an issue? Akin to the Amalja, tempered by Ifrit, these sylphs exist only to serve their deity. Oh. They're not answered to words, only steel. I take no pleasure in this, but it must be done. I don't have any steel. Oh, you just meant fighting. I get it. Ha! Ha! Lame joke is lame. Alright then, so, this is just your standard battle. Pretty standard, anyway. Granted, we're not quite as strong as we would be, but we're strong enough, I think. Lots and lots of fire. Look at it all. Ha ha! We are victorious. How can we not be? Look at all this glorious fire. And we're out. Okay, no more glorious fire. Now we're gonna do with some ice and such. Alright, so Morbol. This is not good. This is the opposite of good. No. Not Stinky One. Yes, Stinky One is scary. Yes, it is. Morbols suck. And I got hit by bad breath. Excellent! This is going well. Wow. Alright. Okay, how are we gonna do this? Okay, we got cured. That's good. I guess we'll focus fire, maybe? Let's try that. Let's try that. I mean, I can heal myself, but it looks like we're fine, maybe? Jesus. Alright. We're no longer hit by the status effects from bad breath. We should be able to take this one back. So let's I think we should focus fire now. Let's not try the whole AoE thing. Are they getting health back too? Are the enemies healing as well? I can't believe it. That's cheating. Only I am allowed to heal myself. No. Okay, we're fine. Okay, that one's not all that strong at all. Let's get out of the way this time. Let's not have a repeat. They are healing. You bitch. I don't approve of that. It's cheating. Alright, so you're down. There's one more of these, and then we fight the Morbol. So, future reference. If Morbol has an AoE bad breath, do not, I repeat, do not let it hit you. It's a bad idea. Very bad business. Okay, we're not even supposed to fight the Morbol the whole way. Well, there we go. That was simple enough. This one is safe. This one was so scared. Klaxio, this one has been worried, so very worried. Is Klaxio unharmed? Still in possession of wits? I mean, and sure, yeah, okay, he's got wits. Kamuxio, and meddling one as well. Why are these two here? Oh, you know, meddling. These two came to rescue Klaxio. That Klaxio was safe fills this one with joy. Kamuxio, forgive this one. This one did not mean to run away from Little Solace. This one was just afraid. That seems fitting. These ones who live at Little Solace were changing, becoming friendly with other ones. This one feared that these ones were forgetting who these ones are, like touched ones did, but this one was wrong. This one can see that now. Yay! Meddling... helpful one. Here we go again, helpful one. This one is grateful. This one will return to Little Solace to be with Kamuxio and friendly ones. Yes, Klaxio. Go be grateful one over in the little village. That's fine. That will be fine. Well, that should see to that. What say we return to Little Solace as well? I, for one, could do with a nice hot bath. Yeah, that Morbol was not fun. Classic enemy, constantly, very dangerous. They're, like, in every instance where you end up with them, they're very dangerous. And, you can kind of see why. With the whole bad breath causing every status ailment in the game, seems like. Not fun. But we did it. We triumphed. It wasn't actually going to fight us the whole way, although we could have handled it. Clearly, we're heroes. We can do anything. But there we go. This quest is done. I think we're going to head back to Little Solace, and then we'll finish up the dialogue to round out this quest, and then we'll see where we go from here next time, because this video's gone on for a decent stretch of time. So let's head on back and see what we're dealing with. Yes, out of the way, peasant dinosaur things. The behemoth is walking. We're walking. We're back. Okay, here we go. Here we are. We're back here. Okay, let's see what Kamuxio has to say now. What say you? This one thought Klaxio was lost forever. Helpful one saved Klaxio. Now these ones can be family again. It's a little knot on their heads. This one has known many walking ones, even many kind walking ones, but helpful one is kindest and strongest of all. Helpful one is hero to these ones. Aw, how nice. We're a hero. Helpful one will bring these ones and walking ones closer together. This one knows. This one would take helpful one to see elder one. But elder one is... Elder one is... What, is he dead? Is he shopping? Is he on vacation? What? Oh, fine. They're not going to tell us. We're going to have to find out in the next quest. So, we're going to cut the video here, and we're going to find out where Elder One went next time. Yeah, I know. But what are we going to do? So, alright then. Bye, everyone, and goodbye, Elyon, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.